While senior citizens are most likely to have a nest egg, to own their own home, and to have excellent credit, and the FBI says that makes them especially an attractive target to con artists.
Here with more this morning is aging expert Anthony Cirillo. Anthony, good morning. Welcome to Charlotte today. Why are seniors more susceptible to fraud and abuse?
Right, I think there's a few things. I mean, I'm the baby boomer generation, but I think the generation, the World War II generation, were, you know, a lot more trusting of people. And I think as you get older, maybe you're a little more forgiving of people. I think that's one thing, that we want to find the goodness in people, so we accept them for face value sometimes. I think the other thing is, you're older, you come in contact with the medical profession, and a lot of things can happen. I had a brother-in-law who, you know, credit card for buying the TV in his hospital room was picked up, and his identity was stolen. So, you know, you long-term care, home health, you know, there's some, you know, most people are good, but there's some unsavory characters as well. Mm-hmm. And then the big thing that people don't realize is loneliness and senior isolation. You know, people, when we just start describing some of these scams, people say, how in the world would anybody possibly pick up that phone and talk to somebody? They're lonely. They want to. And so that's why you can get people to actually engage on a phone for, you know, a long time and possibly scam them.
And the scams seem to evolve and get a little bit more sophisticated each time. So that makes seniors a little bit more susceptible to that. So what are some of the latest?
Yeah, so they're always changing. I mean, 35% of the scams in the last couple of years have been around Social Security. And again, that gets back, there's lots of ways your Social Security number can be scammed, and certainly with the medical records, medical fraud, we've read about that. But one of the more common ones that we're seeing is robocalls. And you would, again, say, why would somebody even pick up the phone? But so it's interesting. Somebody from AARP actually wrote an article. They actually called the person back, you know, which is kind of rare. And they went through the process to see what would happen. So what happened is that they, you know, asked for their name, their birth date, and their Social Security number. Of course, they gave all false information, but the gentleman on the other end said, oh, yeah, we have that right up here. There's massive fraud on your account. We have to issue a new Social Security number. And they said, somebody's actually going to call you from the Social Security office, at which they won't do. And then on your caller ID, because they can spoof IDs, next thing you know, you're getting a call and wanting, you know, to go through a process. Mm-hmm. So in this case, it was trying to get people to buy gift cards and liquidate their accounts and things like that. Now, hopefully it stops there, but even if you've gotten that far where you've given your name, your birth date, and your Social Security number, they can actually go in and open an account on Social Security. They could redirect direct deposits. Basically, they could redirect your Social Security. So it's really something you need to be aware of.
How can seniors prevent this?
So one of the main recommendations is that you actually go on the Social Security site. I think we have a Chiron that actually shows where you can go on the site, and you could sign up for My Social Security. Now, people might say, well, why would I do that if I'm not even Social Security, you know, eligible to receive, but do it anyway. And then what you do is, you monitor, put a little tickler on your electronic calendar every 6 months, whatever it might be, to kind of look at that and see if any of your personal information has changed. And if it is, then you report it to the Social Security Administration.
Mm. So what are some of the common frauds against seniors?
So again, there's so many, but one of the other common ones that have just kind of resurfaced is romance scams, to the tune of, I think, $200 million a year, 25,000 complaints have received. And so essentially somebody will try to, again, preying on particularly older women who are single, isolated, and they'll maybe start on a social media site or an online dating site, and then they'll kind of move off that as quickly as possible and develop a relationship to try to build trust over time, whether it's instant messaging or emails or whatever. And then they'll actually maybe send you some gifts, little things, just to, again, build the trust. And then it'll turn, and then they'll want you to, I have an emergency. Can you send me, you know, this dollar amount or that dollar amount? Of course, that should be number one flag. Don't do that. But then here's where it gets really dangerous. And again, people have done this, and they've gone to jail for it. And they'll start sending you goods to give to other people that were bought on, you know, stolen credit cards. And sometimes it's drugs, and people have gone to jail because of that. So obviously you don't want to you don't want to give that kind of information out. Obviously a telltale sign is going to be somebody, you know, all of a sudden is not available to be, you know, it's a romance. When can I see you? Well, they're never available.
Right.
And then there's also a way to actually track back photographs. You know, people send these attractive photos of people, and a lot of time they're stock photos. So you can go on something called tineye.com. I think we have that as well, and or Google image search, and you could reverse, you know, track the image and see, you know, is this a stock image from Getty or whatever it might be. But bottom line is you shouldn't even engage in any of, you know, that. But it happens.
Good information, Anthony. Thank you so much. Check out theagingexperience.com/Charlotte today. theagingexperience.com/Charlotte today. You can go there for more information. Anthony, thank you.